All right. Welcome back to the 2016 ZBrush Sculpt Off here. Let me get my little things going on here. There we go. I'm your host, Joseph Druss, and this is...
Jessica Drew.
And we are here for the group two for the final 1 hour and 13 minutes of this event here. So this is the almost the last hour in which our contestants will be able to finish their sculpts for the competition. Our sculpt off again is broken into two divisions. We have the hard surface and the organic. Each of those divisions have 12 sculptors, ZBrush artists competing. The grand prize is a Form 2 for each of the groups, which has been supplied graciously by our sponsor, Form Labs. And we also have the belts that
championship
each of the
belts.
Contestants will be receiving, the champions. We currently have our two reigning champions in the room right now, Mr. Eric Sosa and Furio. They are battling it out. We also want to thank our other sponsors for get back to the feed here. So we want to thank Keyshot for providing. We're gonna get some word jumbles here as we go through these.
He needs providing more coffee.
I do. Providing the Keyshot Pro licenses for use with the Keyshot, the ZBrush to Keyshot Bridge. Also want to thank Wacom for providing the Cintiqs and the tablets. We also want to thank Kotobukiya, Good Smile Company, and Funko for coming through and supplying some of our other prizes here, and also 3D4 Medical. So those are our sponsors for the event here.
Yeah, so we appreciate you making this happen.
Yes. So since you've been gone, we've probably had a lot of stuff happening. Let's see what's going on here. Let's go to our organic group here.
That's the hard surface group.
Yeah, let's go.
That's the organic group.
So here we have our organic group here. And so we're down to the final hour. So they have a little over 1 hour left to finish their models and generate the final image for the sculpt off here. And this is going to be voted on at summit.pixelogic.com/sculpt-off.php. And if you look at the very top right of the screen here, the URL is right there. So as well, where you will be able to vote for your favorite final image for this event. And there'll be two categories, the hard surface and the organic, so you get to vote on one of each.
Yes.
One hard surface, one organic.
And it's going to be tough to pick your favorite. Like, everyone is doing something so different that it appeals to different crowds and different people. And what you're seeing now is only a portion of what the final image they're going to submit is going to be.
And they have two monitors on the machine right now, so you're only looking at their main monitor. So a lot of them have been using the ZBrush to Keyshot Bridge, and they've been rendering consistently with their main monitor onto their other screen as well to kind of get a secondary view inside a Keyshot of their meshes. So some of these you may see in ZBrush here and may not have the final until you see it on the voting site. So our contestants again, at the top we have Tan. Next to him, we have Brett. Mm-hmm. And he's doing this hairy, furry, baby papoose.
Yep, Brett's in beast mode.
Beast mode. There we go. Next to him, we have Vic Char. All the way from India.
I love how pretty his sculpt is. Like, this is some, like, meditative.
Yeah, like,
crazy.
Energy infused.
Yeah. The apocalypse wasn't so bad for her.
Yes. Then we have Eric Sosa, who has now implied a rubber ducky inflatable.
I love this. the use of humor is huge. Like, his character already started off as, like, the happiest post-apocalyptic character ever. And then you're like, that's effing terrifying. Why is he so happy that the world ended and he's got a ducky blow up?
A ducky blow up. I love it. Looks great. Next to him, we have Dimitri. And he's finishing his one as well. He's switching back and forth here. And then in our final corner there, we have Joe Mena. And it looks like he's adding some crazy detail now. He's got some skulls hanging off on chains on his sculpt here.
You can never have enough skulls.
No, you can never have enough skulls. It's
Ever.
True.
Now, was the skull included as part of, like, ZBrush, the base mesh thing?
We had some possibly with base meshes, but we did have one of the... base meshes they could choose from did contain skulls. Some of the artists also made instant mesh brushes that had low resolution versions of base mesh of skulls as well. So
they're totally taking advantage of that then.
Yes. So it could be an insert mesh in his case. It could also be just pulled out of the one of the anatomy files we let them choose from for a start. So very interesting stuff there. Let's go over to our hard surface guys quick here. So this is where they are all at for around our final hour of the sculpt off here.
Words.
So we got Steven Anderson up here at the top. And he's still polishing out all these loops and group loops and changing all his designs.
He's going to make the focus on the face of this robot, this very happy robot.
Oh, he's got like a backpack now.
I love him. Sorry. I'm such a sucker for cute. And if you can make cute in a post-apocalyptic
theme. It's
going to
get your vote.
Yeah. All right. I'm not going to tell you who I'm voting for.
It's got like a Sherpa type.
Oh, it's like a Sherpa?
Sherpa, yeah.
He'll take you up the mountain?
Take you up the mountain.
Robo Sherpa.
It's like it's a little bit happier up here. Not as apocalyptic if you climb up the mountain with me.
Yeah, yeah. Get away from all the decimated cities. Join me on my mountain.
The flooding, the terror. Maybe he breaches the, you know, the clouds, like Matrix style. So he carries you up above the clouds where there's sunshine.
Where there's no oxygen, and then he's like, oh, snap.
But there's sunlight.
You needed oxygen. My bad.
He tries to be good. Tries to be good.
He means well. Good intentions.
And then we have Andrea next to him there. And he's got his model on the Q-Shot. He's the one that had the really nice kind of exoskeleton structure there. So
with inner robo guts.
Inner robot guts. So he's probably going to start merging those in and start rendering something.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what his final like composition. Because he has details on the front and the back.
And the back. Yeah, is he going to rotate? Is he going to double up? What's he going to do? And then next to him, we have Furio. Who's the reigning champion for the hard surface stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And he's got his character going on here with all sorts of skulls and spikes and cords and ropes. And
but he's also starting to kind of like pose the character. So the character's probably just going to be giving you the death.
The death, yeah. The
glare.
Death look, yeah.
You know, throwing some shade.
That's right. And we're down to our last hour, so we're probably going to see them start, you know, finalizing their final images, getting their renderings done.
Getting their
and everything
final
else.
Camera.
So, yeah, so probably most of the sculpting at this point has probably pretty close to completion.
Yeah. Now it's like noodling and getting that composition.
And getting the composition.
And also, if they figure out their camera frame, then they can go back in
and back
really
in and
and detail up the things that they need and see need doing.
Yes.
That was a sentence.
I understood it.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. So we got Dennis down at the bottom right. We have learned how to tell our right from left after.
It only took us 5 hours.
It only took us 5 hours. I think it's the screen. I keep thinking it's like a selfie and we're like looking.
Oh, yeah. The you're like mirroring it. That's what I have to do when I name the objects in my scene. Is like I'm like, oh, yeah, this is
which
left
way?
And this
but
is
I'm looking
right.
At the front. Which
yeah, exactly.
Is it? Yeah. I think I always go with the car thing. Well, is the right side of the car? The front side? The left side of the car?
Oh, driver side or?
Yeah, yeah. Yes. I think that's how I end up always thinking about the left and right.
Driver, passenger.
Then we have Lucas Hardy in the bottom middle there. So he's adding some more elements here.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Now, I'm really interested to see how he's going to frame this piece.
Yes.
And exactly like how he's going to make it like fit in a world or whatever render. Because like, it's so high concept that I want to see what he's going to explain with it, you know, because it's like this flying robot skull.
Yes. It's got a very cool design.
Yeah.
I want to see it like, it's almost kind of like the mechanical version of a head crab.
Oh, it's a brain sucker.
A brain sucker just comes in.
Robo brain sucker.
Yeah, it takes you over. It flies in. It's the next level of drones.
Yes.
Amazon's going to own all these. And then in our bottom right corner, we have Joe Grunfast. So the other Joe in here in the competitions, we have Joe Mena and Joe Grunfast.
Mm-hmm.
And he's still working on his model here. He's adding little bits and elements.
Now, the robo portions are kind of embracing this papoose. So I'm curious to see what he's using his base mesh, which this was with his base mesh, right? That he pulled all his robot bits out of.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
I'm curious what he's going to be like sculpting or pulling off of or creating around from this.
Very pretty stuff, though.
It is really beautiful. I love the proportion and the solution of how different, like the legs are intersecting into the hips.
Yeah.
And then the rib cage and the twist. There's some really, really beautiful artistic choices.
So do you have Twitch up, right?
No, I have the live stream up kind of over here.
Okay.
And I'm only
Well, do you want to ask to see if they want us to, since we only have like an hour left of this, we can go in and start doing the sets and go two by two, or we can just keep switching back and forth with the arrays of six here. We're down at the end. We can go off script.
Yeah. So there's only 1 hour left. I just messaged in the chat if you are looking at that at all. We have 1 hour left, and if there's anything you really, truly want to see more of, like, let me know. I'm going to try to look over and glance and see what you guys want to see.
So but I think we can go in and start zooming in on the different
two by
sets.
Two.
Like
you want to see Brett. Got it. Mm. Well, let's go in the 2x2.
Yeah, okay, let's go 2x2s.
Our first group is Tran and Steven, and then our next set is Brett and Andrea.
We'll do this, and you'll get the Brett fix here coming up with the alien babies and the papooses. So here we got Tan and Steven Anderson here. So I'm liking he's adding some straps to the robot
Dang,
here, too.
He's adding so much, like, complicated secondary, tertiary
stuff.
Forms.
Very cool.
It all story tells.
And he's got some interesting stuff in the pack as well, like describing some of this form. So it looks like it has bulk and stuff inside of it. Like he's got that nice.
Yeah. Another that good robot's thing. Carrying.
Yeah, carrying.
Dead climbers from the top of the Sherpa Mountain. He's like, my bad.
He saves them after they get trapped. He's like, people just, they're not happy when they see him. I'm going to take them off the mountain. Yeah, but he has that nice thing. Matchmaker's also a really nice thing. You can take your objects and matchmake, you know, that object onto another one, and it gives a nice kind of result of having an object with something inside of it. So it gets that kind of rough shape there. I don't know if you used it on there, but it could be one possibility there.
Yeah, that's a smart way of handling it.
And if you guys are tuning in too, you'll notice that all the UIs that a lot of these guys use are, you know, generally looking a little bit different. And so ZBrush has the ability to allow you to customize your UI all over the place. And a lot of these guys that, you know, do it professionally to the level of what we have here for the contestants, they pretty much all use custom UIs. So you'll see a lot of these guys have different buttons all over the place, different hotkeys, and they just make ZBrush their own. And this is pretty easy to do. You just enter a customized mode, you can drag buttons around, remove them, do all sorts of stuff. You can make pop-up menus by taking the palette at the top and assigning them to hotkeys. And if you press that hotkey, you'll actually will generate a pop-up menu for that. So all sorts of different things to do to customize your UI to, you know, make ZBrush work for you. So it looks like Tan's here is starting to frame his image.
Mm-hmm. Figuring out his final shot.
The final shot. So we're down to 1 hour. 1 hour left. So he's in good position there. All right. So here we go. We got Brett Briley and Andrea. Oh, so he is doing a back view for that robot.
So he did
carve
cool.
that out. That's pretty cool. So I wonder if he's going to have two of them.
I hope,
yeah.
Snap, he did so much work on the front. To be fair, I'm just like, I want to see everything. composition be damned. Show me all your stuff.
Show me everything.
And I'm really interested to see how Brett is going to compose his very complicated character plus baby in a tube and fuzz. Right now he's adding in like a lot of textural detail.
Yes.
So his final render is going to have all this texture coming in along with whatever shader he picks from ZBrush. Yes.
And that all transfers over with the bridge too. So you can transfer your polypaint, you can transfer your texture maps. And then if it is a material inside a KeyShot that accepts vertex color or texture mapping, UV mapping, you can just drag that material over and hold down the Alt key, I think it is, and it will retain the polypaint information but then apply the material properties. So
Dang.
You end up using the reflectance values on different materials but keep that underlying color and
stuff. I wonder if he's
going to
do just like really creepy subsurface-y.
Maybe. I don't know. We're going to have to see.
Yes. Brett, hurry up!
Andreas
being
looks like
awesome
he's starting to do
and
his
just
renders.
Put it into rendering.
Looks like he has taken a little break here to run out and get a little breather, maybe some water. Probably be back.
I don't blame him. It's warm.
It is warm. All right, let's go to our set three here. See, we have Vikchar and Furio. Furio is starting the prep for his image. It looks like he's transferred the stuff over.
He's not going to do a back view. His is so...
Yeah,
like
he's not going to do a back view.
Really
I think he just
cool
signed
face.
It over and that's where it's at.
Oh, maybe he's like assigning materials.
Yeah. Vikchar has gone like crazy micro detail. Like, look at this.
I wonder how well that's going to show up on the render.
Yes.
I bet you if he applies like really different materials...
Sure, you'll just see a pop, yeah.
Yeah.
It'll be interesting to see.
And Furio also left his desk, so...
Oh, yes. Well,
yeah.
Furio's on smoke break, probably, more than likely.
It's how he gets all this stuff done.
It is. So very cool.
Just super cool. Everybody's just...
We're down to the last hour. They're taking their last break for the final push.
I'm almost done, but Furio is done.
So here we go. So here is Eric Sosa here. I love the ducky.
Oh, he chose to say mom instead
of
ZBrush.
Yep. It is mom.
Yeah. I don't blame him. I mean, I love my mom too. So.
But what about ZBrush?
I love ZBrush, but in a different way.
Not tattoo way? Is
I
that
have
what you're
no
trying to say?
I have no tattoos.
I don't either, sadly.
I don't know if I would start with ZBrush.
Oh, man. So there we go. There's Keyshot there. Oh, I really want him in a bathtub.
I love that there's just a plastic rubber ducky shader already ready to go. It's adorable.
He's just so happy. It's like the muscle juice has just been too much.
So
he's
good.
All giggles now. All giggles.
You have to find simple pleasures in
That's
the
right,
apocalypse.
The apocalypse. He's like, I found this. It's mine.
I found this ducky.
Other
now
people
to
want
find
weapons.
A pool.
He wanted the ducky. And then we got Dennis over here. He's looks like he's he's doing some crazy detailing on this.
Mm-hmm.
Using those insert mesh brushes and then deforming them across the surface. There was some transposing and different moving
so
aspects.
Cool.
And it looks like he's probably going to do a mirror and weld is what I'm guessing.
Mm-hmm.
To mirror all that to the
yeah,
other side.
His whole character is very, very clean, very symmetrical, very planned out. So all this
yes.
stuff makes sense. But it's also nice to have these forms coming in and being kind of like the curves to complement
yes,
all of
the, all the hard shapes
the planes.
And forms, yeah. And definitely the added detail for, you know, break up some of the stuff and sharp areas. Eric's onto the rendering. Looking good here. All right, let's go on to the next set here, set 5. Mm-hmm. So we have Dimitri. Dimitri has gone into the composition phase as well. And we got Lucas Hardy here, who started to add. Looks like he's almost doing some edge masking and then painting some of the sharp highlights in.
Ooh.
That's very cool. Maybe some cavity masking.
Mm-hmm.
So that's making that whole sculpt of his like really pop out.
Yeah, it really is.
It's looking really nice. We got a bunch of layer passes from Dimitri here, and he's going through and assembling them. He's almost kind of like a, from this angle, at least that size with the desert in the background, I'm getting kind of a Darth Maul.
Yep,
vibe.
I definitely see it. Well, it's that crown of horns.
Yes, that helps too.
And the red face.
Man, that's, Dennis's thing is looking awesome. Just inside his ZBrush there, that material and then just poly paint.
Dang.
It's looking really cool. He may be staying entirely inside of ZBrush here for all
yeah.
his renders.
No, I mean and you can, because you can
good.
Light stuff in
yeah,
ZBrush.
Yeah, you can do
all the
lighting,
that.
Set up all your materials, you can use filters. There's a whole bunch of stuff that BPR has built in to light control all
mm-hmm.
those little values.
I just want to see what angle he picks for his creature, character,
yeah.
robot, brain sucker.
Brain sucker.
Amazon's next drone.
On to our last set here. We have Joe Mena and Joe Grunfast. The two Joe slide here. Oh, man. I don't know what... I have no clue. Joe Grunfast is just adding insane.
What?
To this. Like
wait, what? When did that happen?
I don't know. How did we miss this?
Maybe it was hidden and it happened while we were on our break.
It could have been. We gave them a little too much time.
Yeah, we left them unsupervised and some craziness, like craziness happened. Dude, now I'm worried about the baby.
Yes, what is. Yeah, see, you thought he was friendly.
I bet you he heard me say, oh, this is a helper friendly robot.
Baby.
And he's like, hey, hey, hey.
Oh man, this what do you think now?
Dude, it's freaking terrifying. It's like this robot skeleton pulling out of the skin, holding. Oh, good God!
Oh, you thought I was gonna save the baby?
Yeah, no, you guys are get ready with your votes. Terrifying everything.
Terrifying everything.
Dang, I did not expect that.
No.
Wow, I didn't realize I could get surprised. That's what happens when you hide a subtool.
Just
like,
never know.
It's like he's got his good subtools and then his evil subtools.
Evil subtools. He's just been showing you all the nice ones every time we're on him. All right, let's go back to the main spread here. Let's go back to the organic group. So here's all the organic guys. Uh-oh. We've got Eric Sosa's got a background here. I can't remember
what?
The name for these towers, but they were old like forts that were built. And these out in the middle of the ocean.
In the ocean?
Not in my deep ocean. But
no, but I mean, what country?
I want to say around the eastern U.S.
Really? Like, this is our...
I don't know. Let's look it up. Let's look it up.
I don't know how you're going to look that up.
Oh, Google. Google is...
Whatever. I don't trust your Google, Foo.
What?
I bet you the people in the chat will recognize those
they
strange...
They probably will. Let's see if they can, if they can get it faster than
you.
I can. I'm going to... Here. Here's what I'm going to search. We're searching for water forks.
But you wanted a pool? Like, you wanted a little kiddie pool? No. You're getting an ocean with creepy water forts.
Water forts, see?
Although the difficult thing that he's going to have is matching the kind of like feel of the lighting of the image that he's using along
see?
With his... Gosh darn it,
Army
your Google
style forts? Let's see where these are from.
They're from the Second World War.
They are from the Second World War.
But they're not the U.S.
No.
Ha!
Okay, so yeah. So I couldn't remember if they were... This
no,
one sinks and
no,
stuff.
No, but what country?
I don't know. We haven't got there.
Liverpool Bay.
Liverpool Bay.
Oh, okay.
That may be incorrect, but we're going to go with it.
It's the...
Yeah, see, they had a metal grate that would connect them, walk through it. It's very, no. very apocalyptic
oh,
style.
Oh, so this is totally the UK. All right. No, but why?
Oh, man. Look what we got here with Brett. Brett's making some, like, nasty jaws now.
Oh.
Look at this.
These would hold, like, guns and stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, wait. Show me that
They're
jaw.
Like batteries.
Sorry, I'm all looking into... So, wow,
yeah.
That is a really nice texture. I mean, granted, I'm
okay.
seeing a small screen.
Well, we're going to, let's see if we get a little bit bigger here. Oh, and he hit it.
Let's Gosh, see. Darn him working so fast.
Oh.
But some really cool stuff.
All right, we'll go back. We'll go back. If he zooms in, we'll zoom in again.
Yeah. Well, wait. We're watching.
We're watching. So lots of rendering, lots of... Past changes. Men is
oh
on
yeah.
his composition.
Yep.
Dimitri's on his. Tan looks like he's getting ready to do his thing as well. So
oh
I think
yeah.
we're down to the finals here.
It's gonna be so
here we go.
Cool.
Let's
okay, go in.
Go
yeah.
in.
Oh.
You thought I was gonna be Happy Monster too.
No, I didn't think I was gonna be Happy Monster. Once I saw the baby, I knew it was all downhill.
Yeah, it was all downhill. Some
oh
babies
man.
Are good. Some
I
are
just
not.
Don't want to see what his reference screen looks like for all the fleshy
true.
Bits.
Yeah.
Like fleshy bit reference, terrifying 100% of the
yes,
time.
Yes.
Just like Google like fleshy reference. All the Zerg stuff I've had to do was just like
fleshy bits.
It tendons and stuff. I couldn't eat meat for a while after StarCraft.
All right. Here we go. We're going to go back to set one now.
This is Tan and Steven. Getting their final frames, like really wanting to see what their end image is going to be all about. Curious to see how much it's going to be like shader or texture influenced or what they're going to do in post. Heading over to our second pair. Really fast. I know. I'm just
We're going back to second.
I'm just going in order and I'm gonna head off to the third.
We're down to our 50 minute mark here. Mm-hmm. So we have Vikchar and Furio. Furio is finishing his image. Wow.
He really wants to keep that belt.
He really wants to keep that belt.
Now, do they get to keep the belt, or do they have to give the belt to the next person?
So they get to keep it if they win it. But
no, but I mean, do they only keep it for a year until it's then challenged?
No, I think you get to keep it, but you're not the current champion.
Oh, okay.
But does he
so
get
the belt's
two
not
belts?
Taken from him.
That's my question.
then he'd have to compete in the organic side the next time so he can just have different belts.
Yes. It's one like of it's each. Like collecting the Super Bowl rings.
Oh, dang.
Oh, key. Someone might have.
Not over there? There you go.
Lucas. Lucas.
Lucas. Sorry, I had to give the key that I was hiding from everyone.
Yes. Yep, so Vic Char's hopefully getting his render here. We'll see what he's going to do with all those layers.
Well, he does have 50 minutes left.
He does have 50 minutes.
It's not like this is the last 5 minutes.
This
he better
true.
Get it done.
This is true.
This is the real time where they get to compose their final image and start thinking about exactly what they're going to present. So, like, rotate around your model, find the best possible view, and then plop that in. But, like, I am astounded at how fast some of these guys are getting their final images together. Like, I already know what
I told them if they didn't have this done in 3 hours, I was going to, you know, I was going to terminate their ZBrush licenses.
Oh, dang. You
play
rough.
Have the power, I don't have the power to do that, but it was, they don't know that.
Empty threats.
Empty threats.
Back over to Eric and
set four.
Is that Dennis? Yes.
That is Dennis. So he should be getting close to that image. Yep, we did a little symmetry and then asymmetry, pushing it out.
Oh, and he's just going to add some rockets.
Yeah, he's just going to go ahead and just keep adding here. Like, we're not done
you
yet.
You know what? Yeah, he's like, I'm going to save a half an hour for final lighting and rendering.
Yeah,
and that's still plenty of time.
Well, he could have the model being rendered right now, too.
What?
You know, if we use the Keyshot Bridge, you can just send it over, and so he can keep rendering it and looking at it, and adding stuff and sending it back. I mean, it's got to refresh the render, but he already may be working on his composition already, and we just don't see the screen for that.
Man, I really want to try this workflow sometime with all this spare time I've got.
Yes, the spare time.
Like, I love sculpting in ZBrush, and I just love sculpting. And I'm like, finishing the thing? This isn't production.
It's not production. All right, let's head on to our next set here, set five. So we got Dimitri here. He is inside of Photoshop finishing it up. Oh, there we go. We got the key shot from Lucas there.
With glowing eyeballs, glowing robo eyes.
It's looking good.
Do you think that's like a little victorious robot coming out of the robot skull? Kind of like,
I don't know. That's what it kind of looks like.
I think it's
like,
actually
think
just like
just
a
like
propel.
Wings, yeah.
Yeah, I think it's like a rudder to the.
But it. Is it the angle? It looks like it has some asymmetry on it, maybe.
Mm-hmm. Once he removes that box, I'll be able to tell.
Do you think he's going to do an army of these? Like a whole bunch of them? Like a swarm?
Oh, yeah.
We'll see, because he's starting his render right now. So we'll see if he goes in and does. Doing compositing with it and see what he ends up with. So we'll have to check back on Lucas there.
Some really cool stuff.
All right, let's go to our final set, set six, and then we'll hop back to the views of all the things. Do a quick word here on our sponsors. So we want to thank Form Labs for the Form 2 printers that the winners of this 2016 Sculpt Off will be receiving. We also want to thank Keyshot for supplying the Keyshot Pros that the contestants are using along with the ZBrush to Keyshot Bridge. We want to thank Wacom for supplying the Cintiqs and the tablets. And we also want to thank Kotobukiya, Good Smile Company, Funko, and 3D4 Medical for supplying some of the other prizes that the contestants here today are going to receive. So thank you all to our sponsors.
Seriously, thank you.
Yes. So without you guys, these guys would probably just be getting, you know, licenses of ZBrush that they already own.
That's worst
prize. Or we could have been
ever.
Up here like making origami characters or something and then handing them out like,
yep.
Oh, you won.
Or
here,
we could have just
a swan.
Printed their picture really high definition and given it to them. Be like, meh, meh. No, these are cool prizes.
These are cool.
These are worth fighting for.
So after whoever wins this, you know, you got to hit them up after they do it and be like, you going to print that thing? Can I buy it as a garage kit? Yeah.
Dang, that'd be so cool. All right, now we're starting to see exactly this evil
death
robot
baby.
Comp.
Yeah.
Yeah. Show me more.
Wasteland.
Ah, Joe going in and actually really, really sculpting and wearing
wear
and tear on those.
Yeah.
He's not using symmetry. All right, I see it.
Yeah, he told me he doesn't use it. So.
Super pro.
All right, let's go back to the big screen.
Oh, yeah. We could probably do big screen a little bit. One more run through of pairs showing like the really, really big version of whatever they're working on, and then big screens for the last.
That sounds good. We will go that route. So we got our organics again. If you're just tuning in, this is the ZBrush Summit Sculpt Off for 2016. We have the second group here competing. So we have 12 amazing artists in the room with us right now. Mm-hmm. 6 competing in the hard surface competition and 6 competing in the organic competition. The topic for this event was post-apocalypse.
And solid theme.
Yep. And we gave them the topic a little ways out, so they had a little bit of time to practice, figure out what they were going to do. So they didn't just come in here and handed them the topic instantly and said, go.
Can you imagine?
Bit reference. Hey, like, we can do it. When it's on the bike.
That would be the meanest ever. The bicycle.
So we were talking about earlier that maybe for the next sculpt off, we do. Yeah. You know, they have
electric powering bicycles.
So bikes. So you have to pedal constantly to power the machine that you're using for the sculpt off.
Yeah. So you have to be both mega fit, always do legs day, and then also be a sculptor that can sculpt while sweating profusely.
Yes, yes. And we think, I mean, I don't know how many guys would be interested in that, but I think this would be a, I think it'd be pretty big.
Mm-hmm.
I think we could get some.
That's how we get in the Olympics.
Yes.
Sculpting.
And
Olympics.
Yeah, and this would definitely go to an Olympic event. We just need to add that little bit more physical nature there. So you have to power that bike. If you go down, maybe it like depreciates the cores on the machine.
Oh,
so,
man.
You know, like you'd have, you know, machines with a lot of cores, but if you're only pedaling so fast, it's only powering like 2 cores.
Oh, and the head start you'd give people would be like biking ahead of time, so like they can like get a little bit of extra
like a
battery.
Downhill boost.
Terrible. No, I mean, there's so many like ways that you can push people creatively, right? Like surprising the whole concept on them, and then a lot of what people would be viewing wouldn't be the ZBrush sculpting so much as people sort of like figuring out and plotting what they were gonna do. So like mm-hmm. the first half hour or whatever would totally be spent,
you know, figuring it out.
Yeah
that'd like, be interesting
what
too.
What the heck am I gonna
do? What am
do?
I going to do? You've got an hour. And
but
then
I
go.
Actually prefer seeing like people have a solid idea of what they want to do and then just execute
it. Yeah.
Much better competition right now.
But on a bike. All right, let's go over to the hard surface here. So we got, oh, look, drone. We got multiples.
You were right.
I was right.
So he's going to have like a swarm of them in the background
now,
and then one
so
close up.
He's doing this here too. So he's cloning them inside a ZBrush. So unless he's going to manipulate them here and maybe deform them a little. Because you can also instance inside of KeyShot as well. So I wonder what his thought process here is.
Maybe Furio's, he knows how to like position
changing colors.
Well, maybe he chose his background and then decided that
he
this was
that
more harmonious.
Yeah. Or maybe he's doing multiples.
Color theory.
Maybe he's
it
doing
matters
multiple
for
rendos
that image.
And he's going to have like an army of them. I have seen Furio images in the past with armies of robots.
Well, he does have 41 minutes left.
He does.
He could do it. I believe in Furio.
I believe in you, Furio.
So much cool stuff.
Well, there's creepy robot with the baby. That scene is almost looking protecting. It may not be stealing.
It's only because of the blue eyes that you might think that the robot is
kind. If it was red,
kind.
Yeah, okay,
yeah.
I got you.
If it's red eyes, then you're like, that baby's dinner.
But it doesn't look like he has any, like, would he just enjoy the chewing aspect of eating?
Organic biofuel. I'm full of solutions for the
That's
apocalypse.
Right. We got this. Write this down.
Don't write this down.
Write this down. All right, so you want to go into the... Let's go to the sets one more time.
Yeah, I think we can get through the sets
one
more time.
That will probably get us back to the 30-minute mark, and then we'll go in and just keep it to the big groups here. Oh, so here we have set one here. So we have Tan and Steven Anderson.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Steve Anderson's adding some battle damage here.
Nice.
Doing a little scratching.
Yeah, because he kept everything really, really clean and organized and complicated, and now going through and, like, really storytelling.
Mm-hmm.
This robot's seen some sh.
I'm liking this Tan. His, like, just his perspective on, like, the eye is different on the one on the left. Like, almost, like, maybe mechanical.
Oh, that's right, because he's got his, like, reptile eye.
Yeah, yeah. Very cool.
I just really dig his like marble sculpture reference that he totally used.
On it, yeah. It's really cool.
Very, very unique.
Mm-hmm.
All right, let's go to our next one.
I got you.
You can drive this. I'll let you drive
it. And push. All right, what are we going to see?
What's Brett doing here?
Okay, so this is going to be his final frame. It's kind of like a close-up of the hunchback.
Yeah, the baby in the jar. The baby in the jar.
Mm-hmm. And the monster. And he's even adding kind of like a creepy vignette.
Yeah.
Well done.
See where this goes. Filters.
Dang.
I love some random overlays inside Photoshops.
Oh, yeah. I learned some really new, interesting Photoshop tricks recently that I cannot wait to put to use. But I didn't realize how many skills these artists need to have to really create like a stellar final image. Because it's not just sculpting.
Yeah.
It's also like they got to figure out textures and composition, framing, all of that. Really cool.
And we got Andrea here. He's working on his render. So I wonder if he's going to layer this. Because he's got one solid color on this. So I'm wondering, because you can with KeyShot and also with ZBrush's BPR, you can render out the passes and then use layer masks.
Oh.
To go through and pull out the different shapes. So sometimes instead of compiling an entire render in one go, you render it out with one material over the entire surface and then just render out multiples of that. So you'd have, like, say, one with matte cap gray and then one with red wax and one with skin shade 4. And then you take them all into Photoshop, you can apply your layer masking on that.
Yeah.
And then paint where you want each of those to kind of show through.
Dropping knowledge right now.
Yeah, so that's another nice way to do, like, it's in our area of compositing to get different surfaces and materials.
So cool.
All right, let's go to the next set here. This is set number 3. So Victor is now into KeyShot here, is finishing this up. And Furio, he's got the glowy bits. We needed the glowy bits.
Furio lives to please. Oh, he's affecting his lighting setup. It's going to be some like top-down horror lighting. And Victor is putting in an HDRI map to get kind of like really realistic looking lighting. I wonder if he's also going to be using that map to kind of like propagate a background. We will see, but all that detail work, I cannot wait to see his final image because I want to see all of that close up. She's like some crazy cybernetic queen. And evil robots. I like how many evil robots there are this year. Great theme choice. Post-apocalyptic. Like, we're getting everything across the board. We're getting hopeful post-apocalyptic and horrifying post-apocalyptic good and evil robots. Here we have Eric and Dennis. I think at this 30-minute mark, 35-minute, Dennis is going to want to start picking his frame. It's got a beautiful robot in there. I really want to see this come together as like a final image. And Eric's like really rocking it with a great sense of humor. Like, he has a very serious character, or a character that could be really serious and hardcore and kind of terrifying, and instead he's giving it like a really kind of like light side. I hope everyone appreciates that as much as I do. I'm pretty sure you guys do. And then we've got our desert mutated survivor. And our brain drones, our skull brain-sucking flying drones. And this is with Dimitri and Lucas. I see that Lucas is really kind of like framing his final shot, trying to get like the best possible composition for his swarm of really killer robots. And one of our contestants from the earlier session also framed his character like how Dimitri is, kind of a face front, really strong pose that's showing off the portrait a lot. I love the zoom in. There's so much detail to this. And we've got Joe Mena and Joe Grundfeld. Really curious to see what final frame Joe Mena is going to be doing for his organic piece. It's definitely like very heroic, very, you could tell what he does for his day job. Like, this looks like it's going to get printed. Oh man. And then on our right, I think it's wearing a flag, an American flag for a scarf. This robot is helpful and patriotic. All right, and we're just going to do an overview of all of our organic sculpts. You can kind of see where everybody is at. There we go. You can kind of see exactly what frames people are creating and what you're going to end up voting on later this weekend. And you can see up in the top right of our screen exactly what the URL for the voting will be. We haven't collected the final images yet since they're still being made, so voting will be up soon and we'll definitely post about it on the summit.pixelogic.com site. I love how diverse all the characters are.
All right, I'm back. Woo, we're down to the final 30 minutes. This is when it starts getting hectic.
Oh man, last session, the last 30 minutes.
That was the chaos.
It was, everybody was like, the sh** is happening.
Yes.
It is on, serious business. I can almost taste that 3D printer.
Yep.
Yeah.
So what have you been going over? What did I miss?
Well, I just went through the rest of everybody in pairs, and
excellent.
Now I just put up the organic. We should probably switch over to hard surface. So you can see how everybody's framing their final images. We're actually a little under 30 minutes. So.
Under 30 minutes.
Yeah. Got to let all the sculptors know, because they
right.
might be so distracted looking at their screens right now.
Yes. This is when you don't want Louis coming in.
Yeah. We'll just shut the door. We'll be like, no!
Bring in Louis.
No. I'm dying.
So I've got this little breath here. You're tuned into the ZBrush Live Sculpt Off for 2016.
This is a good year. Last year was really interesting and amazing to watch, and then this year's even better. I cannot believe the level of talent you guys brought
growing.
In this year.
It keeps growing.
Seriously.
Well, we did for this year too. We opened it up to the public, so you could submit to be in the Sculpt Off. So you had to send your work in. So next year it'll probably be the same type of system. So if you want to compete next year in the ZBrush Sculpt Off, make sure you keep an eye out for the Sculpt Off submission form. It usually corresponds with the registration for the ZBrush Summit. And you too can be one of the contestants to win this belt, a Form 2 printer, and all sorts of other prizes. So
it's worth it.
It is worth it. Don't be afraid. It's only 3 hours.
Only 3 hours and the pressure of the whole wide world.
And then you got to hear me and Jessica talk about you.
That's true. And I mean,
we're abrasive.
We're quite nice. Honestly, art is art, and everybody's bringing something amazing to the table. I have nothing bad to say about anybody.
No.
Everybody's freaking inspiring and really talented and on a whole other wavelength. Like,
so got Andrea doing the passes stuff now, bringing them into Photoshop, starting to mess with that.
Ooh.
Fury over there doing his final. I think he's putting bloods on the spikes. Is that blood? I think he's painting blood.
No, maybe. Or maybe he's just painting in some color.
It could be.
Or it could just be. Never mind. It's only underneath the skulls. It's probably blood. Forget I said anything. That's a vicious freaking robot.
All right, let's go back to organic. Here we go. 26 minutes left here in the Sculpt Off. We can switch to our overview shot as well so you guys can see what the room looks like in here.
Yeah, it's all serious business. I have never seen fingers fly so fast.
No.
Tablets are smoking.
The panic. So close. 26 minutes.
They can do it. I believe in them. This group today, everyone. 3 hours. They're doing all of this.
In 3 hours.
Fully well-considered character.
From a sphere in some cases.
Yep.
Like nothing.
Yeah, from nothing.
From nothing. To a final rendered image. That's what we were joking earlier that I hope their companies they work for don't see this. They're going to tighten up those deadlines.
Nah. Well, production is totally
this
different.
This is true. And
they also had prep time too. We cannot discount the amount of work that all of these artists have put in before coming here, really considering what they were going to do.
Yes.
And a lot of them like went through
Doing
and practiced.
Test sculpts, yeah.
Yeah, like
all sorts of stuff.
They were like, let me just figure out exactly what I want to do. So that way they created what they feel is the most interesting image and final sculpt for the competition. Like all of these guys are real professionals and they brought that professionality.
They did.
Professionalism. Professionality.
Professionality.
Yeah, I've been talking too much.
It didn't even faze me. She's like, yeah, that makes sense. Total sense. I love it. Let's hop over to hard surface here.
Yes, please.
You can see Jessica and me, we're winding down.
We're really
getting
sorry.
Slower.
It's unintentional.
We're coming to the
we
end.
Are still as excited about these guys
we
as
are.
We were
oh,
when we started.
Oh, what we got here? Oh.
Oh my goodness, is he. That is a really cute baby. Okay, on the bottom right hand, where we have Joe going in, putting an adorable baby face over the baby
it
that
so
is...
It looks so yearning.
That baby looks so trusting of the evil robot. Super
this
evil
is how
robot.
Skynet happens.
This is where Skynet starts?
That's right. In the ZBrush Sculpt Off 2016. You heard it here first. when Skynet starts, this is the reason. Oh, man, I like what Andrea's doing now, too. He's adding some text.
So I just got a text message from Laurent's boss saying that now he's taking all of Laurent's bids for models and having them.
See, I knew the poor Laurent. He's not in here to defend himself.
Oh, man,
either.
Poor Laurent's going to come back to work on Monday and just going to be slammed. It's like, we have
like
really high expectations for you.
We saw that you could do 3 models in the time. You're saying it. You could do 1.
Yep. Laurent will regret the day he showed off his super skills.
The day he could participate in the sculpt off.
Nah, everybody knows he's crazy talented. Trust him. Yeah, everybody here is crazy talented.
Oh man, baby. I'm really liking this, the rendering for the one Andrea's working on now.
Oh yeah.
It's really holding the forms, and I'm digging the text he's putting on it too.
Oh yeah. No, you feel like this is
Look at Steven Anderson's adding a whole bunch of like canvas cloth to the back.
Smart.
That's pretty cool. 22 minutes left.
I love the swarm with the Z-depth fall-off.
Yeah.
So good. Oh, what was the movie with the attack from Mars? Or Mars Attacks. Mm-hmm. Sorry.
The eyeballs.
The eyeballs,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
I would lose my... I would just lose it
if
I saw that.
You could probably 3D print one of those and turn it into a real
And attach
one.
It to a drone?
Yeah.
And fly? Holy... Yep. That would be the scariest thing ever. Like, people are already scared of drones to begin with. And can you imagine if the drone is coming at you with glowing eyes, a skull, and like tentacle grabby things? Yep. You'd be like, I would run so fast.
Let's go back to the organic side. Oh, man. We got Brett Bradley. He's fleshing it out up there.
Oh, yeah.
Ugh, so
wow.
Gooey and nasty.
Fully approve. If this final render makes you uncomfortable, it has post-apocalypse done its job.
Yes. We're almost down to the last 20 minutes here.
Yeah, we're at 21 and a half minutes. No pressure. All the pressure. Every pressure.
Almost 20 minutes left. Make sure they all know.
I wonder if it helps us giving them a countdown, or it makes their heart rate go up and they start
panic
sculpting.
You don't want to have it, happen, and then you're not be ready for it.
Yeah.
So
no, you're right. You don't, but you don't want them to feel like relaxed. You want
no.
The
well, I don't think any of them feel relaxed right now.
No. We gave them too much caffeine.
We didn't.
For them
we didn't
to feel
put
relaxed.
Them in the massage chairs for the sculpt off.
I don't know if I could like sculpt while being in a. Because it like vibrates and stuff. I'd be like, whoa. No.
It's like having a toddler around bouncing your chair while you're trying to sculpt.
How is it trying to sculpt with kids?
When they're bouncing your chair and you're trying to sculpt.
Better or worse than cats?
Better.
Okay.
Better than cats.
Because cats will walk
are
on the
all
keyboard.
Over the keyboard. Yeah.
Have you ever seen people using a dummy keyboard to distract
yes,
their cats?
Yes, I've seen that. Yep. We used to, our one cat that used to do that, we used to distract her with a lamp.
Oh, like a warm spot?
Yeah, warm spot.
Those sunbeams.
She'd prefer to go under the lamp and stare at it rather than get on your keyboard.
So your cat was blind by a certain point in time, I'm guessing.
I don't think she ever was.
Aww.
She always had good vision. She just loved like warm heat spots. But nice. It kept her off your keyboard.
There's also the box method where you just kind of like put a box nearby.
Yeah, and they'll jump in the box.
If I fits, I sits.
Mm-hmm. Now, my current companions are... 2 dogs, so they come to work with me.
Aww.
They sleep underneath the desk. They don't bounce
Aww.
The chair or sleep on the keyboard.
They
so.
Just hang out?
Yep. Yes, remember to save.
Oh, yeah.
You're at the end.
Pretty please save.
19 minutes. Start deleting undo history. All right, let's go back over to the hard surface here.
Yeah, we're going to probably keep it on these overview.
Yeah, so you guys can see how these all finish out.
Yeah, because it's too hard to decide who to concentrate on. We don't want to like go through all of the pairs by pairs and then miss something.
Yes, correct.
So.
Which is why we switched this year to having two screens instead of just one single screen. So we get at least double the coverage that we had last year.
Oh, yeah. And it's also nice to see both organic and hard surface at the same time.
Yeah. If you like the organic stuff, you can see that. And if you like the hard surface, you can see that one too. So I think it worked pretty well. You guys at home, maybe like, it was awful. What did you guys do?
We're going to do even better next year. We're just going to find a way to step it up.
That's right. We're always in stepping it up.
But this year's really good. Like, never mind. This year is awesome. If we do this year again, it'll be still great.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Starting down to our final compositions here.
So cool.
Very cool.
Once again, did you see the American flag cowl on this robot?
No.
Patriotic, saving a baby.
So this could be a good robot. This is We're the back true to good hero robot now.
Yeah. Watch, he'll just switch the eyes to red to screw with me.
To screw with you.
Yeah.
And then it's the opposite. Yeah, and I they'll see, be like, I see no. what this is. So
or
once
turn
again,
it into a GIF and have it flicker red.
Yes, we're at the end here of group two of the ZBrush Live Sculpt Off. This is the second and final group for the event. So we had the first group this morning, and this is the second group. So 24 artists total battling it out. So 12 artists in each class. So we have a hard surface and an organic. The winners will walk home with a Form 2 from Form Labs. So Form Labs is one of our sponsors. Our contestants here are also using KeyShot Pro here, along with the ZBrush to KeyShot Bridge. And we want to thank Wacom as well for supplying the Cintiqs and the tablets the contestants are using. And we also want to thank Kotobukiya, Good Smile Company, Funko, and 3D for Medical for their contributions to the Sculpt-Off as well. So thank you all for making this event happen.
Yep.
We got some eyeballs going in the background. Glowy bits.
Glowy bits.
Oh, look,
bit.
We can see Dennis as his inside
yes.
KeyShot now. Yeah.
Yeah, bottom cool. left, Dennis is putting his into KeyShot and getting cool. it. Beautiful material. Is that straight out of KeyShot? No. Yes?
I'm sure it's heavily tweaked. You can tweak a lot of stuff.
So rad.
But it's also, if he uses any, he had all that poly painting he was doing on it too, and also the material
nope,
from
right.
ZBrush. So
you're so right.
It could be, definitely could be a mixture. So
killer is goes. What it is.
Oh, we got images embedding here. Let's go back to the organic here. Color balancing.
Saving. Rendering.
Saving, rendering.
The papoose levels of glowiness
yes.
are getting adjusted.
Yes.
Oh, they're test tube babies.
Check to make sure we got the contrast here. I'm going to go tag Dimitri and have him check his on both monitors.
Yeah, yeah. Do you feel it's...
It could be a little bit... I'm trying to judge what they're seeing versus what the we're seeing here at the live stream
Got
feed
it.
As well. Just to make sure. Because he has a lot of the dark tones in there and,
You want to make sure all his detail is showing up.
Yeah, and so
yeah,
it's not... Yeah, so it's what he expects it to look like for the final image. So we'll see what he does here. Closer to the... We'll give him 5 more minutes.
Down to 15 minutes. Yeah, go check in on him. What's that? Here, come. Oh.
I'm gonna play that one.
No, it looks good.
How do you see this?
Right there?
Are you just looking at the thumbnail? Like
well,
okay.
Sometimes.
No worries, I was just curious.
Yeah.
Can you click it and make it bigger?
Wah! Nope.
Okay, no, don't worry.
I screwed something up.
All right, so we are down to the last 12 minutes here.
Mm-hmm.
So we went and we had some color balancing stuff here. We're gonna just look with our contestants here because we want to make sure they're getting the best possible renders out of their stuff. We're just getting that because some of these monitor here aren't balanced as well as some other ones. So we just want to make sure that what the artists are seeing on their screen are what we're seeing. And
yeah. Because if we can get a consensus, then it'll work for most everybody who's going to view and vote on these images at home.
Yes. And we don't want it to be, you know, if they're thinking this is going to be like how this is, and then it gets online on your web browser and it looks totally different.
Oh, that would be so disheartening if you would just like work super hard and there's all this detail and then no one can see it.
And so what the images they submit, we cannot touch. So whatever they save out is the final. And those will be the ones that will be put on the voting site. So we noticed one contestant that may have stuff a little bit too dark. So we just wanted to check that out.
Yeah, we've got his back.
Let's go hit up the hard surface guys here. And we're going to do the same thing with things that may be too light as well. Just make sure that...
Do you think so?
I don't know. I'm just stating that we will also look for this too.
Yep.
Down to the end.
That's beautiful.
Oh, there's the flag. Ten minutes left. Down to the final 10 of group 2 for the ZBrush Live Sculpt Off. We thank you all for joining us for this event here.
Mm-hmm. Some super amazing sculpts, and I don't know, we hope this inspires everybody who's picking up ZBrush, mastering ZBrush, using it in work, like trying new things.
Pushes maybe you all to the next level?
Yeah, if all you do is hard surface, maybe this will encourage you to try some organic. If you only do organic, maybe you want to try some new techniques that you've seen here, hard surface.
Mm-hmm. All sorts of different venues. And as we talked about earlier, different industries that ZBrush is used in, so fashion, jewelry, medical, all sorts of things. So you don't just have to be in film and games. You can do all sorts of creative outlets with the use of ZBrush. So let's go to the overview cam here. So here's what the room's looking right now. Everybody's slowly finishing up their renders here.
There's a serious lack of panic in the room.
It is. I'm sure they're all panicking on the inside.
On the inside.
almost there, Jessica. We're almost there.
This is the home stretch.
Let's go back to our final views here. So here's your organics.
So rad.
So really cool stuff through here.
I'm impressed. Great group of talented artists this year.
And there's our hard surface group. Finishing it up. Still going. Do a quick check around here. Get some hand waving.
Yeah, Joe's acting as our technical support, making sure everybody's getting exactly what they need so they can get their final images out. I'm going to switch back over to the organic guys, just in case you wanted to see more. I'm going to switch back over to the hard surface. Too many open file dialog windows up over on the organic side.
Last 5 minutes and 50-some seconds. So now we got the stress of the rendering times, too. Some of these are going a little bit long, and they're cutting the wire. So there's a lot of...
Oh.
That's the worst.
Whew.
You got your piece done,
mm-hmm.
Your thing's like halfway through.
And your render takes too long?
Yeah.
Panic. I really love the composition of the robot swarm that I didn't know it was going to become that, and I'm so pleased he did it this way. It's a whole other perspective.
Yes.
And it looks rad. It has some glowy bits.
Glowy bits.
Hey.
Down to the last 5 minutes. I'm gonna go.
Only five more minutes. Oh, I like everyone who's like zooming out of their image as far as they can to really kind of see if their overall presentation is strong and reads really well from a small thumbnail. Because some of you guys might end up voting from your phone, and then you really want that stuff to sell the character from even a little tiny thumbnail.
Last 3 minutes, Jessica. Last three minutes.
What can you even accomplish in 3 minutes? It's like the last little like brushstroke of light.
The saving. I hope they're all saving their images correctly.
The last save. Do you want to switch over to the organic guys?
Yeah, let's do that. Finish this out here.
There are a couple dialogue boxes that have been up for a while. I think they're working on their second screen.
I think you're right.
The panic. Panic has ensued.
Or they're all super secretive and they want the final image to be like
this
a surprise just
thing.
For
yeah,
voting. Is that a tactic?
It could be a tactic. So once again, for deciding on these, after we collect all these final images, they're going to be up at summit.pixelogic.com/sculpt-off.php. And you guys can go there to that URL and vote for your favorite hard surface and favorite organic from today's event.
Yep.
So that's 12 on each.
Yeah, so you don't have to pick just one. You got to pick two.
Two. One for hard surface and one for organic.
I have no idea who I'm going to vote for. Everybody's so amazing.
I don't know who. If I was allowed to vote, I don't know who I'd vote for either.
It's oh, you don't get a vote?
No, I don't
Sucker.
Get a vote.
Wait. Maybe I... No, I can vote.
You can probably vote.
No one mentioned it.
Well, that's just because I get 10 votes.
Some really beautiful stuff. A lot of them have been zooming out and like really making it a tiny thumbnail to make sure that what they're presenting reads from
yes.
even the tiniest little perspective.
Yes.
Smartest.
So you've got... Which ones haven't you got? All these? Okay, he's here somewhere. He may be here. See if we can find him. But
he was out there.
In the break room. That's where he was.
Yeah.
Yeah. Just to ask him. Just yell out his name. All right, we are down to 1:10 here.
Yep.
And let's go back to our final hard surface one, and then we're gonna switch to.
Just
us here. We're gonna see
minute.
This. We're gonna see this countdown clock. Oh, we might as well switch now. We're coming up on it. All right,
yeah.
Here we go.
You can
we're
see the
down.
Clock behind
yeah.
us.
Yep, we're almost done here. Once again, thanks to all our sponsors.
For real.
Form Labs, Keyshot, Wacom, Kotobukiya, Good Smile Company, Funko, and 3D Form Medical. So you ready to count this off?
Oh man, we're down to 30. Oh, I mean. I'll count the last 10. 30
okay,
seconds
okay,
is a lot to
okay.
count.
I'm 30 right. seconds.
30. Oh, yeah.
Hold
I'm
the belt. This
nervous
is the last time.
For them.
Hold the belt.
Oh, yeah.
Hold the belt.
Yeah, I won't get to keep this after,
no, this
after
is
today.
This is all we get to see the belts, and then they go away, and mine's upside down. All right, ready?
Yes. Right.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Pens
Yay!
Down!
Woo! End of the second group of the ZBrush
You
Sculpt
guys are
off
awesome!
2016. Thank you all for watching. If you want to vote, the vote decision is at the very top there, the URL for that. Mm-hmm. And we're going to stream out a little outro here, which will also contain that information for you guys. So thank
yep.
you all for watching. And
seriously, thank you guys.
From Joseph Drust and
Jessica Drew.
We thank you and stay tuned for other presentations for the ZBrush Summit. So it's going to be going on for 2 days. If you're in the LA area, come on out. It's free. And it's also free to stream it online. We're also streaming it on Twitch. So take care.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.